Well, some firms use space invaders to test school leavers' suitability for jobs on the production line. And today we heard of a 16-year-old spastic boy from Portland near Mansfield who is making amazing progress thanks to space invaders. His head teacher told us that when Tim Freeman arrived at the school, he couldn't catch a ball. But now the space invader has improved his concentration so much, he should be able to go to a normal college in 9 months' time. But why are these machines so hypnotic? Why do they attract such undivided devotion? Well, Peter Higginbotham is a psychologist from Leeds University, and speaking for the invading faces, Vic Simmons, who is the financial controller of a leading firm of distributors.
Well, gentlemen, welcome. I've been pressing the button here. It won't seem to work, but we'll discuss that. Oh, I see. Yeah, clever. Clever, being at the university. Now, being a university boffin in psychology, has it surprised you that these machines have taken off so much?
Not really. I mean, our own students have similar games on our own computers, and it's really hard to get them away. I think there are two or three reasons why they are so addictive. One is the sheer excitement, pressing the buttons and
hearing noises like this. Noises,
yeah. The thing I think which makes you come back over and over again is at the end of the game you've got a score, and it's all, you always want to get higher and higher score. And the higher the score you get, the harder it is to get a higher score. So I think that's probably the thing which keeps people coming back.
But of course, the thing is, you don't actually win any money, do you?
No, but beating the machine, I think, is a big aspect. There's a big sort of brain sort of aspect to it, and the feeling that you can somehow outwit it, I think that's a sort of sense of achievement it produces.
Now, some social workers, of course, while they acknowledge some of the good points about these and quick reactions and so on, some firms indeed use them as testing beds for future employees. Yeah. Some social workers would like to sort of cure people of their addiction. I think you have a theory, have you, how you can actually cure people?
Well, the addiction to this kind of machine is fairly similar to the problem you have with one-armed bandit addiction, which there are several sort of ways you can try and cure that. One of my favourites is you put the addict in a room full of machines and a big pile of tokens, and he has to stay in there for a week until he's spent all the tokens. So by that time, you hope he'd stick to death.
But would that work?
Well, it seems to work in some cases of the one-armed bandit addiction, so maybe it would work with the space invaders as well.
Of course, this is all modern and silicone chip and everything up to date, but it's only really the same sort of addiction as people had with pin tables going back in the 50s and 40s, presumably.
I think it's a bit more sophisticated than that. There really is an intense degree of involvement on these things. I mean, to play it well, you have to really concentrate and press the buttons. Some of the older games, you can sit back and have a drink and chat at the same time. Whereas the Space Invaders, you're really totally involved with it.
Yeah. So generally, as an intellectual boffin that you are, would you say these are a good thing or a bad thing?
Well, I think at the moment it has some bad features, like they tend to be sighted in rather unsalubrious locations. But I think the fad will die out. For instance, the early games, the ping pong games, were all the rage, but now...
But it's so much better now. And here's a chap who can tell us about the future of them. Now, Vic, are a lot of people making a lot of brass out of these?
Well, whenever you get a craze like this that people seem to be playing a lot, it gives the impression that a lot of money is being made. But that's nothing like the case. To start with, these are very expensive pieces of equipment, and the takes have to be shared among various parties. The government, for instance, gets its cut with VAT, and we can't escape them.
There are tales of people making a lot of money in cash every week out of these, not particularly distributing firms like yours, but people, agents that are employed to put them into pubs and clubs and arcades and so on.
Well, like everything else, these tales must be exaggerated, because there's people come to us and say, oh, if you give us one of these machines and we'll make a fortune, and we know for a fact that's not the case.
Are they quite expensive to build?
They're very expensive, yes.
And make?
Yes, they are.
Why? Because it's just a silicone chip and a TV monitor, aren't they?
Well, there's a lot more to it than that, because, for one thing, by the very nature of where they have to be sighted, they have to be much stronger than that. They have to stand up to quite a bit of punishment. They have to be transportable. Yeah. They have to be imported.
So even the invaders have to be careful. Thank you very much indeed for this insight.